Hello children, happy to see you again. I hope you are fine and safe. This is Dakshaini handling biology from Bharathidhasanar Matric Higher Secondary School, Arakkonam. Children, today we are going to discuss chapter 1, asexual and sexual reproduction in plants, 12th standard botany. And this is the last part of this lesson, children. And in this, we are going to discuss about the embryo, study of the embryos, what is the apomixis and what is parthenocarpy. So let us go into the topic. So first we are going to study about the development of dicot embryo, right? Dicot in the sense which has two cotyledons, example groundnut, beans, right? So all we call this as a dicot plants. And the example what we are going to see, the development of the embryo is a plant, Capsella bursa pastoris, right? What is it? Shepherds, it is commonly called as a shepherd's plants, and it is said to be, it belongs to the mustard family. We can see on the roadside. So now let us see the image of it. So this is the image of this picture, children. You can see on the roadsides. Okay, this is the image of the plant, Capsella bursa pastoris. What is the common name, children? Shepherd's purse. And this we can see on the roadsides. So now we can see how the embryo development takes place in this dicot plant. And development of dicot embryo in Capsella. This is the diagram, children. It is the image of the embryo. First, this is the embryo sac. This is the embryo sac of the Capsella plant. And now we know what is this. This is the primary endosperm nucleus. This is the zygote, synergids, and antipodals. And what we say, what we studied in the last class, that is the synergids and the antipodals get degenerated and the endosperm division takes place, and later the zygote divides. And now we are going to see how the zygote divides. And endosperm division, we studied about the nuclear, cellular, halobial and ruminate types, right? And now we are going to see how the zygote divides. The zygote divides, right? It undergo the mitotic division and it forms a two cells. One on the top, we call it as a terminal cell. We call it as a terminal cell. And one is which is at the bottom, we call it as a basal cell. As a basal cell. So zygote divides into two. And later, before becoming a mature embryo, it undergoes many shapes. So based on the shapes, we can classify them into globular embryo and heart shaped embryo and the globular embryo. And later it becomes a mature embryo, and this mature embryo, it possesses the radicle and the plumule. What is a radicle? Radicle is the embryonic root, right? And plumule is the embryonic shoot from which the leaves develop. And since it is a dicot plant, it has two cotyledon. One cotyledon, this one, and another cotyledon is this, two cotyledon. So this is the embryo development in the mature plant, right? And now let us see the example for the dicot plant, that is scissor aratinum. Nothing, children, we say konda kadale, right? Mu kadale also we say. In that we can see how this embryo is present. So scissor aratinum, it is a dicot seed. So now let us see this. First, it consists a dicot, right? So it consists of two cotyledons, and two cotyledons are attached to the fruit wall by the structure called funiculus, right? Funiculus of the ovule become the funicle of the seed, right? We studied in the post-dub fertilization changes. And next we can see the depression, right? When you open the chenodal like this, children, when you open, you can see the structure like this, right? And here some white portion will be present, right, which connects the another seed, that is a funiculus. And if the funiculus is removed, there is some, if you remove this white portion, what will happen? There will be some small furrow like structures, right? So that one we call it as a hyalus. What we say? Hyalus. And chenodal possesses this dicot seed possesses a micropyle, right? You can see, when you take a chenodal in your hand, children, and you see a small hole through which a water get inside, right? Chenadol, when you soak in water, the next day morning it increases in size, right? How, why it increases in size? The absorption of water takes place, that is due to this micropyle, right? And then, so near below the hilum, micropyle is present, and here the embryonic shoot axis, we call it as a plumule, and the embryonic root below, we call it as a radicle, right? And above the cotyledon, we say this region as epicotyle, epicotyle, and below this we say the region as hypocotyle. So this is about the dicot seed. So write the spelling, children. Size arytenum, right? It is a chenadol, right? See how the radical grows, and the outermost covering integuments become testa and tegma. Testa is a outermost covering, brown in color, right? And tegma, it is the innermost cover, right? So what are the structures? We discussed about the funicle, hylus, micropyle, testa and tegma, plumule and radicle. So now let us recall. So the mature seeds are attached to the fruit wall by the stalk called funiculus, right? And the funiculus, what happens after, when the funiculus disappears, it leaves a scar, small furrow like structure, that we call it as a hilum. And next, about the micropyle. What is a micropyle? Below the hilum there is a small pore called as a micropyle. Next, what develops? Integuments develops into the seed coat. The outer integument develops into testa, and the inner coat we call it as a tegment. And embryonal axis projecting below the cotyledon. Below the cotyledon we say it as a embryonic root or radicle, and the embryonic axis above the cotyledon we call it as a epicotyle, and below the embryonic, below the cotyledon we call it as a hypocotyle. So funiculus, hilum, micropyle, testa and tegma, radicle, plumule, epicotyle and hypocotyle. This is about the dicot seed. Now let us see about the structure of the monocot seed. What is this, children? It is a monocot plant, Oryza sativa. Oryza sativa is nothing other than the paddy plant. So now this is the structure, right? It possesses only single cotyledon, and hence it is called as a karyopsis, right? It does not burst to disperse the seeds, what we say, nil, right? And this is the inner structure of the monocot seed, and it possesses more endosperm. The embryo get nourishment through the endosperm. So this is the innermost structure of the paddy, and the embryo is covered by the shield shaped structure. The embryo is covered by this shield shaped structure called as the scutellum. What is this? Scutellum. And here embryonic axis, that shoot we call it as a plumule, and the root we call it as a radicle. So this is here you can see the shoot, plumule, and this is the radicle. And the shoot, that is a plumule, is covered by the protective covering called as a coleoptile, and the radicle is covered by the structure called as the coleorrhiza. So this is the structure, children. What is the endosperm? This is the endosperm covered by the shield shaped structure called as scutellum. It possesses a plumule and radicle. Plumule covered by coleoptile and radicle covered by coleorrhiza. So now let us recall the monocot seed. So the seed of paddy is one seeded, so we call this as a karyopsis. Next, it get complete nourishment through the endosperm. The food is stored in the endosperm. The embryo is very small and is covered by the shield shaped covering called as a scutellum, and the plumule is covered by the what? Polioptile, and the radical is covered by the protective covering called coleorrhiza. So this is an important question, children. They may ask differentiate between the dicot seed and the monocot seed, or explain the dicot seed with an example, monocot seed with an example. So the next topic what you are going to discuss is apomixis. Apomixis without fertilization. With fertilization we call that process as amphimixis. What we say? Amphimixis is a, it involves fertilization, but apomixis does not involve fertilization. Here no meiosis divisions takes place, and syngamy, fusion of gametes, does not take place. And apomixis was first observed by the person called Winkler, right? Winkler, and the person named Maheshwari, Professor Maheshwari, he classified apomixis into two types, that is non-recurrent and recurrent apomixis. In non-recurrent, what happens? The haploid embryo sac becomes the embryo, right? And now we are going to study about the recurrent apomixis. And recurrent apomixis is of two types. One is vegetative reproduction. Vegetative reproduction, we discussed about the bulb of onion, right? And runner, mentha, that is pudina we say, and sucker in chrysanthemum. So such propagation through the vegetative parts, we say it as a vegetative reproduction. And the second type is agamospermy, that is it does not involve the fusion of gametes, and it is of three types: adventive embryony, diplospory, and apospory. So this is the flow chart showing the types of apomixis. Draw this in your notebook, children. So let us see the explanations, the definitions of these types now. So recurrent apomixis, what are the types? Vegetative reproduction, another one is gamospermy. Vegetative means what? The plant which propagate other than the seeds. We can use the leaf, we can use the root, or we can use the stem of the plant to produce the next generation. Agamospermy, that is it eliminates the meiosis and syngamy. Syngamy, fusion of gametes, fertilization does not take place. It is of three types: adventive embryony, diplospory, and apospory. What is adventive embryony? Here the embryo arises directly from the diploid cells of nucellus or integuments, right? In the ovule, right here, antipodals and synergids. So this portion we call it as a nucellus, or the integuments develops into the embryo. That we call it as adventive embryony. Diplospory, here the embryonic mother cell, right, develops into the embryo. So the embryonic others, megaspore mother cell, we can write in short as MMC. Megaspore mother cell develops into the embryo. Example, Eupatorium and Erva. And third one is apospory. Here the megaspore mother cell undergoes the division, right? And what happens, children? Megaspore division, four haploid cells are formed, embryos are formed. All these get disappeared, and the nucellar cells becomes activated and develop the embryo sac. All the haploid embryos get destroyed, developed cells get destroyed. And we studied right in the megasporogenesis. One megaspore mother cell develops into four haploid cells: unisporic, bisporic, tetrasporic. All these four haploid gametes get destroyed, and the nucellar tissue is involved in the formation of the embryo, right? So such we call it as apospory. It is seen in the plant Hierarchium and Parthenium. Parthenium, mukutipu, we can see on the roadsides, right? Mukuti chedi, like that. It will be, the shape will be in the shape of the star. The flower will be like small cauliflower, right? So now we are going to study about the polyembryony. What do you mean by polyembryony, children? Poly means many. If more embryos are formed, It is said to be polyembryony. It was found by Anton van Leeuwenhoek, and this is the structure of the polyembryony children. So occurrence of more than one embryo in the sea. So based on the origin, we can classify them into cleavage polyembryony. Formation of embryo by the cells of the embryos are other than the egg. Other than the egg, synergids, antipodals becomes the embryo. And development of more than one embryo sac within the same ovule. More embryo sacs itself form. And activation of some sporophytic cells of the ovule. So this we can see in detail. So types of polyembryony. The first one is cleavage polyembryony. Example, orchids. Orchids, the example, the beautiful flowers which we use it for decoration, right? Orchids, example for cleavage polyembryony. And next type, formation of embryo by the cells other than the egg, right? Other than the egg, first one, synergids in the plant Aristolochia. This is a plant, Aristolochia. Here the synergids develops into the embryo. And next in the plant, Ulmus. And next the plant is Balanophora, right? So here the endosperm becomes a embryo, right? So now let us see the example, synergids, Aristolochia. Synergids become the embryo. Example plant is Aristolochia. Next, the antipodals becomes the embryo. Example is Ulmus. And endosperms become the embryo. Example, Balanophora. So now let us see other two types, that is development of more than one embryo sac. Example is Casuarina plant, Savukku, we say in Tamil, right? Savukkumaram. So that is Casuarina. It is an example for the third type, that is development of more than one embryo sac. And last type is activation of some sporophytic cells of the ovule, that is either the integument or the nucellus. Example is Citrus and Syzygium. There, this is the image of the plant, right? And the last topic is about the parthenocarpy. What is parthenocarpy? Without fertilization, the fruits which develop without the seeds, we say it as parthenocarpic fruits, right? These parthenocarpic fruits does not possess seed, children. So now let us see the advantage of this. What are the significance of this parthenocarpic fruits? Example for parthenocarpic fruits, banana, grapes and papaya, right? So first is one, the first significance is that in horticulture, right? Horticulture in the sense thottakalai, they give more preference. Nowadays we also prefer the fruits without seeds, right? So more important for the economic aspect in horticulture. And second one is that seedless food, they have great commercial importance, right? We more economy developed due to this seedless fruits. And from the seedless fruits we can easily make the jams, jellies and fruit juices. Everything is very easy to make from the seedless fruits. And finally, we instead of no seeds are there, right? So edible portion, the flesh part of the fruit is more. So this is the advantages of parthenocarpy. So with this, the chapter 1, asexual and sexual reproduction, comes to an end, children. Go through the topic well, and nearly almost 12 parts, 13 parts are in this lesson. Go through all the parts, and at the back of the book, the record, that practical paper is given. In that, we have completed nearly 6 experiments in the first chapter. So in your record notebook, start drawing the diagrams and the note. No need of writing the aim. Write only the points, diagnostic features and the picture. So first 6 experiments comes under this first lesson, asexual and sexual reproduction in plants. Go through the topic well, children. Write the study material in your notebook, study, and send the assessment in the school WhatsApp. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.